God's way is not some revelation that I concocted or thought about. When I begin to preach, I'm preaching about something that had already made itself manifest in my life. And I've already seen the hand of God turn it. And I've already seen the heavens open. And I know you hear people talking about the things like that all the time. And you know, we're under an open heaven, or you know, the heavens are open. And I don't think we understand the facet of what God is trying to say to us, and the power of it, and the authority of it. And knowing that you have to be chosen to have an opportunity to have an audience with God. And we take that for granted. We act as if God has to talk to us. And we act as if when we come into the house of God and we feel the presence of God, that I'm feeling the presence of God. But I want to help you with something. Everybody that's in this room, you got to begin to know the difference between the presence of God and the familiar spirits that will pretend to be of God. Because those are the things that will deceive and watch this, and distract the believer. Because the enemy can't get you to smoke. The enemy can't get you to drink. The enemy can't get you to act a fool anymore. The enemy knows you're not getting ready to go and become a pole dancer. So the way that the devil deceives the believer is making them think that they're in a realm that they're not in, or making them think that they have something that they do not have. Well, then how do you know that you're not being deceived? Because every day of your life, you are hunger and thirst after God in such a way that every single day you would feel like I don't have enough. I don't care how many experiences you have with God, you would still desire more, because in this hour, the creature is going to begin to moan and groan for the Creator. The Bible says that that which God is about to do, nobody will be able to satisfy you but God. Somebody said nobody satisfies but God. Somebody said nobody satisfies but God. Say it again, nobody satisfies but God. Nobody can satisfy you but God. Nobody. And I think people are tripping and thinking that stuff can satisfy. Nothing. Watch this. If you're in this spirit tonight, I cannot tell you that you have come to the end of your spiritual deceptive road. And nothing else after this night will satisfy you but God. You can try anything you want to try. You can go anywhere you want to go. But if God is not in it, nothing. You'll walk around like a crook. side. How long their fingers are. Jesus. What size shoe they have. What size hands they're going to have. It's all sitting there in the born, in the born, in the very beginning. When you are adopted in your mother's womb, everything that you're going to be, everything you are now, was sitting there. So therefore, when we are born again, we keep trying to make God fix us. And God said, I don't want to fix nothing. I want to do something new. I want to bring your ministry to another birth canal. I'm not giving a cover to me. I want to bring until the time comes. My God comes out. Some of y'all don't even understand why the devil is fighting you the way he fight you. Y'all may, because guess what? The enemy can sit back. You ain't got to say nothing. When Jesus was on the road, the demons walked up on him and said, why have you come to torment us? Because that fool yourself, every demon in hell knows that after this night, oh, you didn't hear me, you didn't hear me, no. I said, after this night, hell is going to know who you are. The earth could not contain me. I had to bring myself in the form of a baby, but I wasn't a baby. He said the word wasn't a baby. I had to sit my form in the frame of a baby. He said that's the reason why when Mary got to Elizabeth and she embraced her, the power that was in the word called John the Baptist, a baby can't do that. He said we need to understand something, that many of the people in the body of Christ, they're waiting and they're going on a lot of fast and doing a lot of rituals because they don't even understand what sits in their belly. cried and said, I got a breakthrough. You dance and you shout and you respond to the word and you say, I got a breakthrough. But the proof that you really got a breakthrough is when the wrong news hits you here and up here you cry. to me. You know, we don't know what's going on. I'm not getting nobody to talk back to me. You better recognize what the word says. Because if you're going through something, let me help you with what the word says. It says not the devil, but it is the Lord that is giving you the point of adversity and the water of affliction. Because I'm getting ready to change your direction. Are you kidding me?
Yeah.
Thank you. caught. 2 months later, the phone rang, and it was a woman saying, "Is this the one you to buy that priest no more sheets?" "Yes, it is. You done changed my life and set me free. Your house is on my desk, and I'm giving you back your house. I'm signing back you. House number two." Didn't have no car. Had Range Rovers and Rolls Royces. Walked in the bank because God said the portal was open over my head. Would have got me a Range Rover, walked in the bank. The lady said, "How was your credit?" I said, "I got bad credit. My sister was with me." Walked in the bank, and the lady started saying, "Are you the one in the bottom of that preacher?" I said, "Yes." She asked me one question, and I went to preaching in there, and women started coming, and I started giving the word of the Lord. By the time I got through, she said, "I'm gonna prove your truck and ask your sister what she wants. And I'm gonna prove her too. I'm not giving her a lot of talk back to me. Because I said, when you find it on the head of the pack, and you tell the Lord you are my only hope, and you stand on the word of God, and the portal opens up to your head, no weapon and no good thing will even come."
People in the body of Christ that's willing to give me a fear.